So from your perspective and current understanding of how we can use, how businesses can use on production large language models, foundational models, do you see, what would be, what are the similarities you see to MLOps? What would stay in a similar way? What is completely not needed? What type of jobs to be done are missing in traditional recent MLOps stack? So kind of a diff. We have MLOps stack. Okay, we had DevOps, right? We added MLOps. There was a diff. We discussed that, and we are adding large language models to the picture. What is the diff?
I think between LLMOps and MLOps, so there's two components here. So when you're talking about LLMOps, you can think as a prompt plus the model, the large model that you're using as a model itself, like the conjunction of them as a model. And from there on, it will behave very much the same as a regular machine learning model. So you're going to need the same observability levels, the same things that you need to take care about on deploying that production. On the create side, though, only now we're seeing a little bit more taking prompts as its own artifacts that you need to version, that you need to discuss, that you need to provide the right people ways of changing that, that you need to measure, that you need to explore, that they will have different behaviors on different models, that any change. So the life cycle of the prompt itself, there are some companies I've seen that are starting to implement it. So having a prompt registry where the product manager can go and change the prompt without needing a backend to go into the code base or a front end to go into the code base to change that themselves. That is one of them. And that's an early one, because right now, at least, you only have a prompt that you probably populate with data, but, or meta prompts or second layer prompts or build up. Yeah. But the further level is prompt generating prompts, and that level we haven't explored yet. So there's another whole level of ops over there that we don't know about yet. So how can you manage ops that generate, like a prompt that generate prompts or pass on flags? For example, I can have a prompt where I pass an option that appends something to the prompt. Okay, be short, be small, be concise, for example. So that development of prompts will become its own language, programming language that we need to, like, functions are defined as prompts. You pass arguments that are prompts in itself to these functions, and that will change a lot on how we do it. So a little bit of the agents now, that's a little bit of what I'm talking about. How do you manage your agents into your stack? How do you manage versions of agents or what they're doing right now, the impact of them into the end, when you have like 5 or 6 different agents interacting. So there are a lot of challenges that we don't really know about yet, because it's so early on the process. It's like 2 months that this became like actually usable on product.
And in most use cases, just wanted to add observation that in the most use cases, if it's on the production, there is human in the loop. Sometimes the human in the loop is a customer, right? Especially if we are talking about the chat type of experience. But I'm curious to see use cases of foundational models in the context where human is not available, like predictive maintenance, demand prediction, credit risk scoring, like things that you would like to truly automate without having human in the loop. How it will behave, how we would be able to test, validate those, like, I'm not even sure whether we should call them models, right? Models and prompts and agent configuration. Another question that's I'm curious what you think. How or will we, and if yes, how will we connect foundational models with more classical deep learning, machine learning models? Would it be connected via agents or differently or not at all?
I think it will be through agents, because agents is the current, is a very broad abstraction that you can pretty much include anything as agents. It's really easy to say agents because, well, you can do that with agents or policies or whatever. But I think so, because that's how you provide more context. So, like, for example, search is very complicated when you have too many labels that you cannot encode in a prompt. So you need either a easy way of finding, like a dumb way of running a query that you have an agent or a tool. Some of them name this as tool as well. So you have a tool that you give your agent tools, basically. So this can be very simple as running a query. This can be very simple as saying something, or this can be more complicated as making a request to an API that predicts. And you could say that the agent will learn how to pass the right parameters to this API, for example. You'll still be using generative AI because you'll not be coding the whole pipeline. But some parts, it makes sense. Even if you have something working, perhaps it's better if you split off some into deterministic chunks that you know what's the output of that specific tool that you want.
So my last question, I would play devil advocate here. So maybe GitLab should skip MLOps part and just focus on large language models ops part. It's going to be quite likely bigger market. In other words, will we need MLOps when we would be using large language models? Does it make sense to invest into it?
I think so. I think we're still learning the boundaries of when to apply ML, classic ML, and why every model has its own places where it's better and where it's not. And LLMs are as well part of this. I always have this. So there will be cases where regular ML is better. It might be that LLMs will become like you first deploy your feature with LLM and then improve with software and then improve with machine learning. So ML becomes the third level of optimization over there. I don't think LLM will kill ML. I don't think that's like nothing kills anything. Like, so people have been saying that Ruby would be dead and COBOL would be dead and Java would be dead. And I don't know. Decision tree would be dead because now you have neural networks. Even if it's just to keep the simplicity, sometimes you don't want those more complicated features. You want something that you can have control of, that you know what was the input and the output. Whether GitLab should focus on LLMOps and MLOps, I think that's a tough question. But I think for now, at the beginning, right now, until we start learning what is LLMOps, MLOps is a better focus because we have a better understanding how this fits into GitLab itself. But it's something we are thinking about, like how to use, because we're also using LLMs internally, right? So we are dogfooding our own problems with how to deploy AI-backed features. So we are learning with it. And yes, those could become a product eventually. Those could become prompt management could become a product eventually. But at this point, even for us to handle our own models, the model registry is more of a concern rather than a prompt registry or whatever.